Dennis and Henny from the One Waves, and we're here in Barcelona at the Polo Club.
The last time we've been to Madrid was 8 years ago, or almost nine, and so the club was sold out and the audience was just perfect. So this is a great gift for us to come back after such a long time and have such a nice show. So gracias, muchas gracias para la audiencia en Madrid.
Well, we realized we wanted to try something different. We changed a little bit in the whole structure around the band, so we chose new management, and we kind of have a new record label. Like we always went with BMG, but now there's Sony, like many new people, very young team, very motivated, and also we wanted to try out a new producer to give some fresh air and to give some, like, to have a different view on the band than we had in the old team that we worked with. And it worked out really great. It's like I think he had a hard time working with us because we are pretty hard to work with, like really striving for things and then really discussing a lot of things, but in the end it worked out perfectly. First, they were a little bit irritated, I think, because it's like the fans, they got stuck with the three old records, and like then there's 8 years in between, and for us it's like a natural transition to do something new with all the different projects that we did, listening to different music, making all the other experiences, and for us it just felt natural to do something different.
We came together not to feel bad. So we came together to feel good again. And so this is the reason now to be back again here in this combination and reunited the Guano Apes, because we felt that in the past that something's missing. So as you told, we made a lot of other projects and stuff like this, and something missing all the time. And so then when we came back or rehearsed for 2009, for us it was felt so naturally at that time to be back in this band again. And so that's the reason after the festival season 2009 to record a new record in 2010 and release it in 2011, now come back here in 2000, blah 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 blah. And no, it's for us it's great.
Definitely. Even though that wasn't the first thing that we thought about, of course, Bel Air attracts to more people or to different people than the old records. And I think we've spoken to a lot of people who say, you know, I've never been so much into Guano Apes because it was too heavy for me or too dark or I don't know. And but now I really like the new album and I usually listen to techno or something like that. And that's a big compliment. Our future projects, well, we're at the...
The plan is that we split up again, because the reunion was such a great success that we now split up, and then came together next year.
It's always nice to have the comeback bonus, you know, everybody's happy, then the band comes back again. Well, we're gonna have a busy year. We're in the middle of the second leg of the European tour. We're happy to be back in Spain, and we're going to go to Italy and Germany and Benelux and Portugal. And then it's the summer festival season again, which we're really looking forward to. And let's see what we're going to do in autumn. I think it's going to be a busy year. Well, you know, music videos for me are the most boring part, actually, being a musician, because you keep it's even more waiting than making music. Doing film is even more waiting, because everything's got to be set up, and if they change the set, they need to set up the lights. It's like you keep waiting and eating and catering and what. It's awful. No, but I think when we started, music videos were a big part of the success of a band. Having them being played on Viva or MTV and all the other channels, it helped us a lot to be known all across Europe. And I think it still helps us a lot if we go to different other countries, that people know the band from the from our history, from musical history. And but they don't make such a big, it's not such a big thing nowadays, because sometimes it's even a little bit strange and absurd. Like, you spend a lot of money doing a video, and then in the end it ends up like a small thing in bad quality in a flash player somewhere on the side. And but I think it's still important that the people are able to see the bands and to see them in a little bit better quality than on the YouTube live videos.
In the past, we really were into the music videos. As Henning said, nowadays it's more an introducing for the band, or to have live shots, or have just the faces in the camera. And it's really hard to make a good story in a music video. And so nowadays we really don't care about music videos most of the time. It's like, okay, we're doing it. And when people really want to see how we are, came to the live shows, and then you can see the real Guanoids. When you don't have a good script or a good story, and you want to have a good video, then it costs a lot of money.
I can't really remember when I saw the last music video.
Yeah, a long time ago, right? So.
But I'm usually, at the moment, I'm more interested in things like TV Noir, which they have like little live performances, unplugged acoustic performances. So I think at the moment I'm more interested in seeing that real stuff rather than looking out for music videos.
I only can remember now a past video, so most of the Radiohead videos are really brilliant, and they really don't cost a lot because the ideas were brilliant at that time, where he was flooded by the water. I don't know the name of the song, do you know it? So that was brilliant.
Or when he... Here comes the flood.
Here comes the flood, yeah, right. Or while he was driving away with the car and the gasoline, burning gasoline line was behind the car. So really easy ideas, but perfect video. So I really can't remember this one, but that was, wow, it was 15 years ago now. Hello, we are the Guano Apes, and you're watching
Music Click TV.
Muchas gracias.